Make sure you guys smash that subscribe button if you guys are fans of the content being posted onto this channel to always be in the loop with more content similar to this, and be sure to hit the video up with a like if you're enjoying the content. And with that being said, let's begin. Now, in order for Resident Evil 8 to stand out amongst its predecessors in actually being one of the most impactful Resident Evil games of all time, Resident Evil 8 needs to introduce an element to where there is a major character death within the story that creates tension, desperation, and a sense of hopelessness for our character, in a sense to where Ethan Winters is now left in having to witness not only one of the most gruesome deaths a character could have in the game, but given the fact that Capcom is actually planning on introducing different elements in the game, a more horrific style to the enemy's approach, and a more grounded narrative of Ethan having to be surrounded by wolf-like men, werewolves, zombies, witches, and other cult-like figures, this game is shaping out to be one of the most promising games within the franchise. So to further add on to its overall effectiveness, what the game needs to include is a major character death in order for the game to solidify itself as being something different versus the rest. Now, there needs to be somewhat of a sacrifice, which of course is going to divide the fandom, in a sense to where nobody wants to see Jill die, nobody wants to see Claire die, nobody wants to see Leon or Chris die, nobody wants to see Jake die, nobody wants to see any of the older cast members actually be picked off here. But to solidify this new organization, to solidify the enemies, and to have this game be talked about for many, many years ahead, what Capcom needs to desperately do is have something different in the story versus having to have said mercenaries or said characters having to be introduced to a corporation, only for these characters to ultimately overrun and overtake these corporations and enemies, in not having these enemies actually feel like a threat. So these enemies, these new enemies, these new occultists like members in the game need to present themselves as actually being threats to Ethan, actually being threats to Chris, actually being threats to whoever else is in the game, because originally Resident Evil 8 really wasn't going to be Resident Evil 8. Instead, they had the code name of calling this Resident Evil Revelations 3, but somewhere along the line, the developers had a change of heart and they wanted to actually cycle through, change up a few things, and slap on the logo of Resident Evil 8 on this title in giving us a continuation based off of Resident Evil 7. So with that, why not introduce an element to where we do have a new organization, we do have a new cult, and they actually managed to capture someone, they actually managed to hold someone hostage, only to kind of bait Ethan and perhaps Chris in, only for them to learn and find out that these people that they have captured, or said person, are killed on the spot after having to be revealed on who they are and essentially how they've gotten here. So that in and of itself actually introduces lots of tension, because what more do you do from a narrative standpoint after witnessing, as an example, Leon be killed off, or Claire be killed off, Jill be killed off, hell, bring back Billy Colon, have him be killed off, or someone, as an example, to see them actually be killed in the most brutal way possible? Would that not only set the precedent for future Resident Evil games, but also, if they develop Ethan in the right way, and they execute his overall characteristics to where it feels more important, and the character can actually resonate with the players, then only then could he ultimately carry on a legacy in being everlasting in the franchise rather than being a totally bland character. But even then, what I believe that Capcom needs to do is introduce a Thanos-esque kind of villain, to where by the end of this story, we actually get to see how for the first time, there is a shift within the Resident Evil franchise, to where instead of our heroes having to drive off into the sunset or having to be rescued on a helicopter or set sail on a boat, instead, the villain is the one that actually wins. I think that this would ultimately set the narrative for a potential Resident Evil 9, especially following the events, if something were to go down involving Chris and Ethan and said characters, to where the villain actually gets the better of everybody and gets away with what they were originally set out to do. So this in and of itself would create a situation to where now the viewers and the audience is left wondering, what do they do now? What does the main character do now? In a sense of where they can create another Albert Wesker per se, except instead of having the personality traits that Albert had, this said enemy or enemies could be totally different in nature, in having more maniacal and sinister motives than any other before them. And I think that this would work because by the end of Resident Evil 8, instead of ending everything off the way normally they would, what would be pragmatic for the overall series is to do something different, is to divide and introduce different elements that we've never seen in Resident Evil before by picking off and writing off said characters, by introducing a narrative to where the villains or the villain actually ends up winning. Would that only then separate Resident Evil 8 from its predecessors compared to Resident Evil 7, Resident Evil 6, Resident Evil 5, 4, 3, and also branching off to where Resident Evil 8 also feels different by comparison to the remakes, because as of course we already know, the PS5 and Xbox Series X are scheduled to debut during the winter season of 2020, and with this game having to drop in rumored 2021, this would be a great addition for the next gen consoles in having players look back on the memorialization of Resident Evil 8, in a sense to where once this game came out, it introduced something so different right as the beginning of the dawning of the new consoles were to be ushered, and now we have the brand new next-gen consoles having to set in. What great way to have people talking about Resident Evil 8 than by having something so different happen to where it blows the mind of everybody playing it. So by the end, I want to get your thoughts in the comment section below about what you guys believe Capcom needs to do to separate this game by comparison to the rest, and some of the features and things that you would like to see be incorporated in the game that would make this game very different by comparison to the rest. Again, thank you all so much for watching. Thank you all so much for your time. If, of course, you guys are new, smash that subscribe button. Give this video a big thumbs up. If you guys are simply stoked, ready, and excited for Resident Evil 8, Resident Evil 8 right now is being heralded on being such a different game that we can only expect for Capcom to do the best they can within their own ability to give us the best Resident Evil possible. But will that be the case? Are we going to see possibly one of the best Resident Evil games of all time? We're gonna have to wait and find out. Thank you all so much once again, and we'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys down in the comment section below. Have a great day, everybody. Peace.